Old Red was one of the ornriest yet I'd seen at the big rodeo. He'd bite you and kick you and stomp out your life. Old Red had never been rode. Meaner than sin, wild as the wind that blew on the Montana plains. Old Red was one of the last of his breed and wasn't about to be tamed. From Idaho, a young cowboy came to ride in the big rodeo. The young cowboy's name was Billy McLean, and Billy had never been thrown. The greatest desire filled a young Billy's heart to ride this old outlaw called Red. He drew him one day, and I heard Billy say, I'll ride him or drop over dead. Old Red was wicked down there in the chute. He was kicking and stomping about. Billy climbed into the saddle with ease, then yelled, turn him loose, let us out. Old Red came out with his head on the ground, his back hooves were touching his nose, trying to get rid of the man on his back, but the man went wherever he'd go. Billy was raking Old Red with his spurs, from his tail to the tip of his chin. He was doing right well, but Billy could tell this outlaw would never give in. Old Red was running straight for the fence, suddenly stopping and then he reared on his hind legs, then fell on his back, taking poor Billy with him. There was a hush in the crowd and they knew this would be Billy's last ride. The saddle horn crushed Billy's chest when they fell, and under Old Red Billy died. Old Red lay still, no more would he move, the cowboys that seen it could tell. In trying to throw Billy off of his back, Old Red broke his neck when he fell. Out in the west is a place where they rest this cowboy that never was thrown. And 1 foot away, resting there neath the clay, is the outlaw that never was.